Notre Dame will start things off with Sydney Palazzolo, one of the best servers on this Notre Dame side, and she'll start things with a service ace. What a way to draw first blood for the Irish.
Yeah, that's Palazzolo going right at the freshman, Haley Pierce. Pierce has been struggling with an injury for the first half of the season, being asked to do a lot tonight, primary attacker and primary serve receiver.
It's the 32nd ace on the year for Palazzolo, who's one of the top in the country in serving aces, and Notre Dame looking for the touch, won't get it. The attacking air, and the Hokies will get on the board to tie the set back up at one. Well, we're early here, and it brings up the first server in Ava Francis, the redshirt sophomore. And Francis has really stepped up into a key role for Virginia Tech as well. Heavy hitting swing for Notre Dame.
That's trouble.
And we'll get a whistle in favor of Virginia Tech on a double hit by Notre Dame. Now the big question, Jake, we were talking about it before the game, is who is Notre Dame going to go with as their setter? Nicole Drunick, the grad transfer, listed as out tonight.
Yeah, Drunick's been really good tonight, but can't go, dealing with an injury. Tonight it's Fiona Schrader. Don't know a ton about her. Hasn't played a lot. At least in the setting role this year.
Right now, Notre Dame fighting through a lot of attacking errors so far, and it's almost been the Irish shooting themselves in the foot early to give the Hokies a 3-1 set one lead. But Ava Francis sails it on a service error and a side out back to the Irish. Now we talk about players who have been out. We talked about Nicole Drunick for Notre Dame, but on the other side, Virginia Tech has a couple of injuries themselves and a couple players listed as out tonight.
Leandro Manuel Duran is probably the most impactful of that. You know, six rotation starter, six rotation left side, best passer on the team, I think. Takes a ton of swings for Virginia Tech. She's going to be hard to replace.
Virginia Tech doing a nice job playing defense there. Some good digs, but it's not enough for Ava Lang, the freshman.
That's a nice move here from Liliana Rodriguez with the pancake. But Lang's just got too much coming back in transition. Goes high seam over the block.
Some low serves early on for Notre Dame, and Dupre gives her first big swing. Head in the antenna, and Notre Dame will get the point. And we mentioned how 4-4 in the ACC, taking on a 1-7 in conference play Virginia Tech squad. This could be a big win for Notre Dame to work their way back up in those ACC standings that we hit on at the top of the broadcast.
Yeah, I think, again, it's a big opportunity here for Notre Dame to take a step forward. I mean, it's a program in transition. Selena Rockwell coming in last year, take over. They made a big investment into the program. First year was rough, I think, which was as expected. But the trajectory so far in 2023 has been upwards. And, ooh, a big swing.
Heavy hitting swing from Ava Lang, and it will work out for the Irish as the dig ends up going out of bounds.
I don't know.
Just that heavy hitting arm of Ava Lang, the California freshman for the Irish, and a big pickup for Salima Rockwell. Was talking to her earlier this week about how she wants to build her program in just her second year at Notre Dame. Said she wants to go the traditional route, getting freshmen and carrying them through all 4 years. And so far, the freshmen have been, and sophomores have been, a big piece of this Notre Dame team. They're really young.
Well, I think that Salima Rockwell, she's been around a long time. She had a ton of success as an assistant coach and associate head coach. One of the best recruiters in the country, and coming back into the game after taking a few years off, you know, that those skills don't go away. And I was talking with one of her staff members before the match, Paul Conser, and he mentioned to me how excited they are about their incoming recruiting classes in 2024, 2025, should be pretty highly ranked. Notre Dame's an attractive place to play. They have a national recruiting footprint, and they've already made the decision in the last 10 years to go for it in women's volleyball when they hired Jim McLaughlin 2 coaches ago. They've made the investment, so I think that, you know, to see success in the recruiting ranks come after that is not surprising.
Elena Dupre in the midst of all the action. And it's Ava Lang yet again. That big number 22 for the Irish has just been delivering the heavy arm. We expected a lot from Palazzolo, but it's been the freshman who's been delivering the heavy arm.
Yeah, Lang doesn't hit for a super high percentage. She's going low seam right there. Kara Lewis has to get shoulder to shoulder or at least hand to hand to try and close that seam. You got to make Lang swing cross or line. Can't let her just swing down the middle.
Elena Dupre gets the touch and it's point for the Hokies. Early on in this set, this has been a close back and forth battle between the Irish and the Hokies.
Well, I think there's a lot of feeling out happening, and it's early. Long way to go, Tyler. And you know, they're checking to see how the looks match up with scouting reports. You know, how does it look at game speed? You know, what system is Notre Dame going to run? Madrunic out. It looks like Selima Rockwell is going to start with a 6-2. We've already seen Fiona Schrader. Now that she rotated the front row, they've subbed in Harmony Sample to set the other half of the 6-2. So right now, Notre Dame is always going to have a back row setter and is always going to have three attackers in the front row.
Notre Dame goes with Maisie Alexander, pretty much only comes in for service, the sophomore out of Portland, Oregon. And a nice little volley quickly ended by Ava Francis. Ava Francis has really been stepping up into a big role, averaging about 3 kills per set. And she gets the point aiming for Maisie Alexander, who assuming the scouting report shows that she only comes in for serves. So a decent target there from Ava Francis. Gives the service back to the Hokies. Too far wide goes a swing from Charity McDowell. Well, you mentioned the formations, and one thing that Selima Rockwell was talking about earlier this week about Marcy Byers' squad is how they change things up, that they mainly run the 5-1 and rely on Hannah Borer as their main setter, but can switch things up, play 6-2, and have several players that play on the outside, and that it's harder to scout when you move a lot of people around.
Yeah, and I think that's a product of they've struggled, Virginia Tech has, in the ACC play a little bit, with only one win over Syracuse, and I think as they got their lineup and rotation pretty settled, they kind of ran into some injuries and into some tough matches. So I think she's moving some people around. Big roster. A lot of different pieces that can be tried out there, and some opportunities to try different people in spots and see if someone's going to play well that night.
Fiona Schrader, the junior out of Ankeny, Iowa, didn't play last Friday against UVA but returned for Pitt and is the server now. Big block on the front, but it goes in the way of the Hokies on a decent swing. Mentioned that feeling out process close in the early set, and again, it's Ava Francis who's been delivering those swings. Heavy arm there, and it's Fiona Schrader this time for the Irish.
Yeah, and Ava Francis there in the net for Virginia Tech on the block. It's a good swing, though. Cross court.
Rotated through with Palazzolo back serving.
So from Palazzolo on the...
And Peterson, the swing, the dig goes out of bounds, and it's the point for the Hokies.
That's been a big change for Virginia Tech this year, moving Sydney Peterson to the middle. She played middle at, she has a background at that position, played primarily opposite last year. Someone who has shown to be a good slide hitter this year and very effective. That's a nice swing from her.
Well, Notre Dame has been trying to get those swings working early. A lot of players have been going around the front line. They get it to work there. And right on the net, it's more so been a front line attack for Notre Dame early on.
Yeah, Palazzolo is really their primary option out of the back row. And if they're going to be in a 6-2 formation, a 6-2 system, they don't need to set as much back row because they are going to have a three-hitter phase the entire time.
A solid set in the swing. Perfectly dug out by Virginia Tech. and it's a battle that the net goes under, and it's a point for the Hokies.
One thing I've seen so far here, Tyler, is both teams, they're not picking good angles here. A lot of these swings are into the block, off the block, middle of the block, and just kind of poorly executed blocking maneuvers. That's a good touch right there. Someone's got to pick that up.
The attack goes into the net by Lauren Tarnoff, and this is just kind of another one of those errors that you were mentioning for Notre Dame. Sydney Peterson on the serve, and a quick whistle will go straight back to Virginia Tech on a double hit.
Yeah, so when you're in a 6-2 rotation, you know, Fiona Schrader here is back row. You cannot pass tight. She has good size. I mean, she's 5'11", 6 foot tall. You see how tight that pass is. That's actually a pretty good set right there. 2023, we're not really supposed to call those doubles. But when you're running that 6-2 system, you want to leave the pass a couple feet off the net. Let your setter, that was a tight pass. That worked out well. But you want to not make your setter play tight to the net because she can't. She can't go over, she can't attack, she can't block. Nice quick set there. Lauren Tarnoff.
Tarnoff, who had her third best hitting percentage of the season against the number 8 team in the country in Pitt, who Notre Dame played in South Bend last Sunday. The big arm of Lang once again coming up. The freshman has been producing early on for the Irish.
Now watch this jump serve here, this jump float kind of hybrid here. From Lucy Trump. Watch how high she gets up on top of it, drives that ball down into the court. It's a tough serve.
Tarnoff again trying for the kill. Big swing on the other side. Ava Francis able to earn it.
I'm a big fan of being aggressive, and I think that velocity is underrated in this sport. And Francis just takes kind of a knockover third attack there and rips it for the kill. Bet you Notre Dame will be blocking that next time.
Freshman Haley Pierce finds a service ace. And it's changed quickly to a service error.
Yeah, line judge had this in. Our up official, Wayne Clark, overruled. We're going to get a challenge from Marcy Byers. I saw it live and had a pretty good look. I'm saying that ball is out before I even see a replay. I think that's a good overrule on the R1's point here.
She says, obviously, she honors everyone, but, and although Jessie's breast cancer came back earlier this year, as of 2 months ago, she has officially beat it again. Guys.
Well, great stuff. Glad to see that she's beat it yet again. And so far, Notre Dame coming back from the break and an immediate point for the Irish, and will certainly be an inspiration to see Lucy Trump playing not only Dig Pink Night last weekend, where she recorded her season high of kills of 18 on Notre Dame's Dig Pink Night against Virginia, but we'll see what she's able to do tonight on the road for Virginia Tech's Dig Pink Night. And Notre Dame going on a little bit of a run. That service ace that was turned into a service error by the overturn has really shifted the momentum for the Irish.
I think you're in the middle of the set here. This is your opportunity as Notre Dame to really pull away, try and get up to 20, develop a 5-6 point lead, and then you can kind of coast your way to the end of the set.
And a solid dump. Harmony Sample able to find the floor.
Yeah, that's a nice move from Sample there. Seen in these 6-2 systems how much more popular this set over move has come over the last couple years. It's kind of two-handed. Jump set dump that technically the ball cannot be entirely above the plane of the net for that to be legal with a back row setter. Somehow we never, hey, how does Sample set, you know, and how is that different than Schrader sets, and how is that different than Trunick sets? So it's tough. The attackers are doing a good job so far, even though Notre Dame's only hitting 179.
Alyssa Menitzis giving the serve for Notre Dame, and in its attack straight into the net for Ava Francis. Now, would you say because of Drunick being out tonight, it's a lot harder for Marcy Byers and this Virginia Tech team to know what they're looking for with these new setters for the Irish?
No, I think if you're Virginia Tech, you'd much rather have two non-starters setting than a starting grad transfer setting. I mean, you're in a better spot because if this was the best system for Notre Dame, this is what they would do all year. This is what they have to do to adjust to an injury. So for Virginia Tech, you want to put as much pressure as possible on those setters who don't play a ton. You got to serve tough, make Notre Dame pass poorly, put those players on the run, trying to scramble a little bit.
And Notre Dame has been benefiting from some of those big swings, but as we just saw there on an attacking air, there have been times this set that's taken their hitting percentage down, where they've been making a few mistakes that have kept Virginia Tech in the set.
Yeah, Tarnoff's got to put that away. I mean, as simple as that. It certainly can't be a hitting error.
And it will be yet another one. This time it goes out on the veteran Palazzolo. The high point transfer, Sydney Palazzolo, getting the air, and it puts Virginia Tech, who was down in this set, 19-14. It's been a 3-0 run for the Hokies. A service air will give a side out back to the Irish, but it was a decent look for Virginia Tech to climb back into this set. Virginia Tech also readjusting to this home crowd, a 5-game road trip for Virginia Tech, finally getting to return to the castle. Maisie,
yeah,
Alexander.
Your reward is Notre Dame and Louisville at home. That's not the best homecoming.
No, not too much. And it's Sydney Palazzolo earning one of her first kills of the night. We haven't called her name too much yet.
No, not at all. And that's her that time going off of Bohr. Bohr's playing, you know, she's probably the weakest blocker out there, but she's a setter. Her job's not to block. So Palazzolo going right at it. It's a great dig right there from Benitez for Notre Dame.
Block out of bounds will give the point to the Hokies. We're gearing up right now for a pretty entertaining finish to this first set. I mean, both teams within three, and only Notre Dame so far crossing that 20-point mark. And it's the grad transfer out of St. John's, Ileana Rodriguez, doing the serving honors for Virginia Tech. Punched over, and that's another, in my opinion, ball that Notre Dame should have put away.
It's got to be a kill.
Right.
It has to be a kill. I mean, it's an overpass, and I think that's Schrader getting a little cute with it and trying to just kind of redirect it one-handed. It's like, just hit that thing. Just bounce that. You only get so many of those in your life. That's better swing.
A better swing, this one. Coming by way of Fiona Schrader, the junior from Iowa.
So it's got to be fun for Schrader, because we see Schrader here on the right side. You know, she's played a ton this year on the right. You know, good attacker. I think that she has a nice live arm over there, hitting 242 on the season, and now she's being asked to set half the match too, which is, you know what, probably pretty fun for her.
Serving on this time as well. Schrader getting the full experience. It's Palazzolo going for the block.
That ball got blocked right off Palazzolo's chest right there before it went out of bounds. So Schrader kind of, she's on the run here. She really hangs this one super high. Palazzolo's doubled the whole way. You want to try and swing high, high hands, tips of the fingers. Try and break someone's fingers. But if you hit their palms or their forearms, you're going to get stuffed.
And it's put Virginia Tech back within two in the opening set. Last season, you talk about both these teams played twice, once in South Bend, once here in Blacksburg. The winner of the first set, both times it was Notre Dame, but went on to win that game. Both times was in four sets. So this first set, I think both coaches realize how important this is.
Ooh.
For the primary setter in Peterson, transfer from Nevada, trying to finish the job, couldn't get it done quite yet. But it will be Notre Dame getting a set point.
It's a really pure swing here from Sydney Palazzolo on not even a pipe. This is really just a bailout pipe there after Schrader dug the ball. Nice reach, full swing, hit it hard. Usually good things happen when you hit the ball hard.
And it's Sydney Palazzolo, one of the better servers for Notre Dame, trying to finish the job on a set point.
That's a wonderful pass there from Sierra Cates. They got to find a way to convert that.
Well, Lucy Trump, an attacking air, will give the Hokies the serve, trying to get back to at least 24 points. to avoid Notre Dame from winning the match, or winning the set, excuse me. And it will be Ava Francis charged with the serve. And a swing goes out again, and it's Notre Dame. The attacking errors starting to add up a little bit, putting Virginia Tech back in this. Charity McDowell with the attacking error.
I mean, Notre Dame has 12 hitting errors. They're hitting 071, and they still have two set points.
But a service error will end the set. Notre Dame going up one set to none. We'll see if Virginia Tech can respond in the second set. Hey, we'll take a short break. Be back here from Castle Coliseum on the ACC Network Extra.
You figure Notre Dame had 15 kills and a block and an ace. That's 17 points that they scored. Yeah, they gave up a ton to Virginia Tech. Virginia Tech's going to have to find a way to generate offense of their own and score off the serve and block game, score in transition and serve receive, attacking.
Will be Hannah Bohrer.
We got the music still on here when we whistled for first serve.
Well, got that figured out, and Hannah Bohrer will be the server. Pretty good numbers when it comes to serving. 16 aces on the year, and she'll get one right off the bat. Second consecutive set, Notre Dame led off the first set with a service ace. Now Virginia Tech does it in set two.
Yep, I think that a serving game is so important. I mean, serving truly is defense. It's how you set your defense, how you take the other team out of their offense.
No service aces for Virginia Tech in the first set, so that's their first of a match. And a battle on the net will go towards Virginia Tech. Just one of those non-traditional battles where it's not set, bump, swing, but instead just a pushing battle at the net.
Yeah, it's just a bad set there from Fiona Schrader. No connection there with Charity. With Charity McDowell.
And Notre Dame trying to find some rhythm. On the other side, Sydney Palazzolo had four kills in the first set, but looking to get a bigger role coming up in this second set for Notre Dame. Transfer out of High Point. Joined Notre Dame and is really set up into the role, and she'll get her second ace of the night on just a beautiful ball that dove down and hit the floor.
Yeah, it's a nasty serve. That's just a nasty serve. Hopefully you can fight it off. You know, number one goal in serve receives, don't get aced. On a serve like that, truly just try and get it up in the air. Again, tough serve. Much better job there from Sierra Cates.
Well, this time it's Ava Francis able to send this one into the third row of the crowd off a dig attempt by Notre Dame. That's an excellent swing there. And now Francis will be the one serving it up for Virginia Tech. Dig pink night here from Castle Coliseum. Notre Dame joining the squad in another nasty serve.
That ball dropped about a foot and a half in the last 3 feet before it went out of bounds. That thing was an absolute missile. I thought that was going to be 6 feet long. It dove. What a serve. And that one's 6 feet long.
Tried to do it again, couldn't quite replicate, and it goes back towards Notre Dame. But I was mentioning, even Notre Dame playing along with the Dig Pink Night here in Blacksburg, the Irish wearing their pink uniforms, Virginia Tech, the white jerseys, pink lettering, and their libero in all pink as well, and Ileana Rodriguez. Sydney Peterson sends a ball a little wide, and it's back towards Notre Dame. Hattie Monson, the senior out of Morris, Illinois, was just her and Fiona Schrader, the two returnees that played every set last year for the Irish, as Elena Dupre finds the kill. But so Lima Rockwell has been having to deal with a lot of newcomers to this squad. Dupre just getting it through the hands of Lucy Trump.
That ball's in.
The swing that goes out. Ava Lang. It's more so seemed like Notre Dame is going towards Lang rather than Palazzolo so far.
Yeah, looks like we're going to have a challenge here, Tyler. Call on the floor was no call from the line judge. Wayne Clark, our up referee, called it a long out point for Virginia Tech. Notre Dame is challenging here. That was right on our corner. I had a pretty good look at it. I think that ball's in. That's a really tough call for a line judge. I did it for a couple years at the college level after getting out of coaching. This is the hardest ball to call. It's right at your feet. You might get a look at this. That's in.
Yeah,
that we don't see. We can't see it hit, but that ball's in. Yeah, that's a very, very quick challenge here. Yeah, that's a tough. Line judging is tougher than you think it is. And that, to me, is one of the hardest calls to make, is that ball hit hard and flat right at your feet, because you just don't know. If you know if it hits you, it's out because you're standing out of bounds. But that one right at your feet is really tough. They got it right in the end.
Well, the right call was made even after the challenge. And it's Bohr trying to set up for Haley Pierce. Pierce is in her first game back here at Castle Coliseum since just the second game of the season against Quinnipiac, and it's good to see her back in that rotation for Virginia Tech.
Absolutely.
Went out with a broken knuckle. How often do you hear about that against Quinnipiac?
I'll show you my hands on camera sometime. You can see what my knuckles look like after a lifetime of volleyball. It happens. It's tough. I mean, it's one of those freak accidents that, you know, you're used to taking, you know, getting drilled in the hands and getting, you know, jammed fingers and such, but occasionally you break something or something like that will keep you out for weeks and weeks and weeks.
Well, the knuckle seems to be doing just fine. Earning a service ace is Haley Pierce, the freshman out of Charlotte. And was talking this week to Marcy Byers, head coach for Virginia Tech, and those preseason, those non-conference games are really those opportunities to warm up some freshmen, and it seems like another call that could go either way. Looks like we'll get a challenge from Tech.
Yeah, the call on the floor is Elena Dupre, long, out of bounds, so point Notre Dame. Nobody had a touch.
Enough evidence to overturn. So both challenges have been overturned.
Yeah, wow. I mean, I think you can see Tarnoff's hand move a little bit, his finger, but it's hard to say that sets a standard of, you know, of conclusive.
And I think the better news for Virginia Tech is Haley Pierce will continue her service. She already has an ace on this rotation. Freshman will send it low over. And the swing getting through, that's Fiona Schrader. Side out, and it goes back to Notre Dame.
Yeah, Kara Lewis closing late there. She gets there, gets her hands on it, but she's not able to get square, so she's still facing the attacker, which means she's kind of facing out of bounds. Ball rattles in, rattles around a little bit.
And a board trying to save this ball, and it's Elena Dupre going down to the floor. A touch and a point for Virginia Tech.
Guys, during the last timeout, I heard from Coach Marcy Byers when she was there sitting with her Virginia Tech Hokies, and she seemed very calm and poised while sitting down and talking to her squad. What really stood out the most, that she really emphasized that it was only a couple of plays here and there would bring them back in it, and that they just have to got to hang tight against this good Notre Dame team, and they'll be back in it as it appears as happening right now, guys.
Well, thanks, Snells, and so far that momentum does seem to be towards Virginia Tech. Had a really good rotation when Haley Pierce was the server, and they find themselves with a 3-point lead, a solid block attempt from Francis and Lewis.
I think that's sage advice from Marcy Byers. I mean, your conference matches are tough, and you're going to lose sets. And losing set one is not a huge deal unless you overreact or panic. So to stay calm and keep working and keep doing the things you try and do every day, it's good run and transition. Go to your go-to attackers. Go to Kara Lewis. She leads you in hitting percentage. Go to Sydney Peterson. Go to Haley Pierce if you can. Like, set your best players. Do your best stuff, and it should be good enough if you play well.
Sierra Cates came in to serve, and a solid attempt for Notre Dame. Just can't quite get it over the net. It's a point again for the Hokies. And Notre Dame has seen enough to call timeouts. Maisie Alexander, another one of those just server roles that coaches like to use in the modern game. For Virginia Tech, trying to earn that momentum back after the timeout and can't quite get it there. An attacking error for Kara Lewis. And that lead, it's still a decent lead, but dwindling for Virginia Tech after the Rockwell timeout.
Yeah, Lewis on the slide here, you know, it's a little high, a little inside. You don't want to make hitting errors long out the middle back. It's okay to make a hitting error long wide, long down the line, but if you're going to hit to the middle of the court, you got to hit the ball in the court.
Weak attack for the Irish, and it sets up Haley Pierce off the net, and the freshman earns another kill.
Yeah, and for Notre Dame here, I think they're expecting Pierce to really crank one off this D ball. We call this attack out of the right back of the back row. And they're deep. They're looking for a rocket. And I just think that you want to make her take that swing and hit one hard past you before you expect it. So she gets the one off the tape. They're not quite ready, kind of on their heels. Ball hits the floor.
A side out straight back to Notre Dame server Ileana Rodriguez. The transfer out of St. John's doing the serving for Virginia Tech. You only get one chance before it flips back over to Notre Dame, and it's Fiona Schrader. Not a typical server for the Irish. Only one service ace, no errors on the year, and almost got one there. Good recovery by Virginia Tech.
Oh.
Set up and a amazing block by Virginia Tech. And again, that line of Borer and Peterson acting strong. Can't get it quite the third time, and Palazzolo able to finish it.
Peterson almost had the Kong block there. That's what we call that one-handed block. She almost stuffs it one-handed. Oh, such a good move. Nobody tries it because it never works, but it looks cool when it does.
Almost worked there. And we'll go back to Schrader on the serve for Notre Dame. Borer setting up for Pierce, but a great solo block coming straight up to the line. Charity McDowell, the senior at Indianapolis.
Yeah, I think Notre Dame's made a good adjustment here, really making sure to commit a blocker to the back row attackers. It's an interesting kind of in-between. It's not really a pipe attack. It's kind of slow. I'd like to see Pierce, if you're going to use her out of the back row, get her on something up-tempo. Let her take a hard swing in system.
Solid swing there for Virginia Tech. A couple of points ago, it's mentioning Charity McDowell with the big block for Notre Dame. Last weekend, she led a block party against UVA, 5 on the year. Season high is 7, so McDowell has been that frontline leader for the Irish.
Well, that's what you want your middles to do. They have to lead. They have to lead the block the same way your libero leads the back row.
A set, and Lucy Trump tried for it, and we'll get a violation given the point straight back to Notre Dame.
The general feeling is if your middles can't contribute on offense, like, you can still be a very good, successful team. But if your middles can't block, you have some real problems. It's the opposite for left side hitters. Left sides can't block, nobody really cares. But if they can't get kills, you need to make a change.
Palazzolo will serve it straight into the net, giving a point to Virginia Tech and a side out. Dupre comes back into the game. Ava Francis. Her mom, Kim Hayes, played volleyball at Ohio State and Arizona as well. So Ava Francis following in the family tradition, playing D1 volleyball over at Virginia Tech. Solid set, but the swing goes too wide.
I like the up-tempo. I like that tempo for Palazzolo right there. A little bit quicker. means the blockers have to stay in the middle of the court because they're not, it's too quick for blockers to be spread and then come help the middle block. So it ties some people down to the middle of the floor.
Well, there's one of the obvious outs. You were mentioning if it hits you, it's out. Well, there's an example.
If it hits you, it's out.
They had that challenge not too long ago where
this is Trump just trying to go down the line, just a little inside, catches on the side of her hand. Tell you what, three quick hitting errors here from Notre Dame. Spreads that lead out again to 5 points, and the chance here for Virginia Tech, if they can generate some more points off their serve, to maybe get bust this thing open here.
That's three in a row for Virginia Tech. This time the block will come for Pierce and Peterson.
Yeah, that's a really, really strong move there for Pierce. Because it's meat. Because not only it's one thing to get them in, another thing to make sure all of their courses transfer. And if their courses don't transfer, you might get them in, but then they're going to be ineligible because they haven't met progress towards degree requirements. Sorry, we're getting the NCAA rulebook insider here. So it's tough at a high academic school like that. But the transfer portal in general has been making it easier for athletes to find the right school and for schools to find the right athletes. I think it's good.
And for a second year head coach at Notre Dame, like Salima Rockwell, able to build her team quicker rather than having to build from the ground up. Well, Sydney Peterson earning the point.
All the way down, yeah, got a little bit out of tempo there. Notre Dame did, and Peterson just able to hang long enough to get the block. The dig from the middle from Peterson.
We'll get an early whistle and another violation. This time it favors Virginia Tech. A second violation we've seen, one for each side.
Yeah, it's Notre Dame in the net right there.
Well, it certainly will help the Hokies. Leading now by 7 in this second set, trying to tie this thing back up. Notre Dame taking the first set, 25-22.
Yeah. So Borer tries to go pipe there to Francis. Francis isn't ready for it. You know, that's a quick attack. You have to be loading, making that approach before the setter touches the ball. Otherwise, you're going to have to just run up and tip it over like she did. Gives Notre Dame a free ball. They're able to convert right away.
Lucy Trump on the serve straight off the net, and a solid finish for Ava Lang.
It's kind of like being the roll man in basketball. You set the pick, you got to roll hard to the hoop. If you don't, you're not going to be ready for the pass.
Lang finishing the job. Lucy Trump, the sophomore out of Florence, Kentucky. Borer, a solid set for Dupre, and is able to target the libero and able to get the point.
Yeah, big swing from Dupre here. Just bangs hard cross court. Gets a little bit wide on her. Swings hard, deep corner. That's a great place to hit the ball as an outside hitter. There's only one defender out there. It's a libero. She's going to be a good defender. But I'd take most outside hitters one-on-one against a libero on a hard cross swing.
Dupre trying to rebound.
See if Notre Dame goes here on the free ball offense.
Solid swing and a good dig for Virginia Tech. Haley Pierce, who's the server, sending it back over. And Lauren Tarnoff able to target Virginia Tech's libero and Ileana Rodriguez in order to get the point. The Irish trying to work their way back into this set.
See, one of the things I'd like to do here if I'm Virginia Tech, because Notre Dame is running a 6-2, because they don't usually do it, take that third ball that has to be a tip. You know, you're not going to get a swing on it. Send that at Harmony Sample and right back. Make the back row setter dig it. Teams that run a 6-2 all year are used to that, have a plan, and know how to play out of it. Well, let's see how good Notre Dame's plan is, you know, in this situation. How well do they execute?
Notre Dame trying to fight back into this set. Now, Jake, we talk a lot about, you know, 5-1s and 6-2s, but just exactly what does that mean from a formation standpoint?
Sure. 6-2. We got a high touch off the block here. Don't know if Sleeper Rockwell is going to challenge.
Looks like she's reaching for the
she's
card.
She's thinking
but
about
won't.
It. She's asking. Not going to challenge. That's where you hope one of your players turns around and is like, yeah, I touched it. So a 6-2 means you have six attackers and two setters out of the six players in the court. It means there's always going to be a back row setter. And as they rotate front row, they play three rotations in the back. As they rotate front row, typically modern volleyball, they'll get subbed off. And the right side hitter who rotates back will get they'll get subbed off. And you'll bring on a setter in the right side to switch for them. So you're always going to have a back row setter. 5-1 means that there's five attackers and the setter plays all the way around. Plays front row and back row. Hannah Borer is doing tonight for Virginia Tech.
And Marcy Byers talked just how important Hannah Borer is to that 5-1 formation that they use a lot in attacking air against Notre Dame. They've had a lot of errors tonight, but they've managed to remain in the game, including winning that first set.
They're down. They're hitting 143 here, which is an improvement from set one, but they're losing now. And so the reasons for running a 6-2 are maybe your setters are small and they don't block well. You don't have a big enough setter, so you want to put a front row player, a hitter blocker on the right side to block for them. It might be that you have six awesome hitters, and if you only run a 5-1, one of those kids doesn't play. There are teams like that. Wisconsin's a great example. They're number one in the country right now. They're running a 6-2 most of the time because they're loaded. Everyone has their reasons.
Well, it was Salima Rockwell talking about just how hard it was to figure out what Virginia Tech was going to go with, as Virginia Tech has switched it up mid-set sometimes between those formations, that 6-2 and that 5-1. So far in this second set, it seems like Virginia Tech has been finding some life with that 5-1. And Kara Lewis able to get that set from Hannah Borer, who we were just mentioning, and giving Virginia Tech a set point.
I think for Virginia Tech, this is their preferred system. They want Borer to run the show. She kind of took over that main role last year, and she's been the primary setter all season for them. I think she brings a lot of creativity to the position.
Ileana Rodriguez on the serve for Virginia Tech, and she'll have to try to rebound. Ava Francis sending it back over on a set point for Virginia Tech. Palazzolo saves the set for now for Notre Dame on a solid cross-court swing. On the other side, it's Fiona Schrader. Server for Notre Dame, trying to keep the Irish in set two. And Borer, a dump on the net. Looked like she was going for the set and dumps it over. Virginia Tech will win set two. We go set one for Notre Dame, set two for Virginia Tech. We're tied at one, heading into the set two break. We'll take a short break, be back here on the ACC Network Extra. Dame, we talked a lot about that heavy hitting arm, and it's been out to play so far today here in Blacksburg.
Well, we knew Palazzolo was going to be a big factor. She has twice as many attempts as anybody else for Notre Dame tonight, but she's only hitting 154 so far.
On the other side for Virginia Tech, it's been Ava Francis who's been leading the charge, the redshirt sophomore.
Yeah, Francis has been good. I've actually been very impressed on swings like that right there, out of system, taking some chances out of the back row and on less than perfect sets. If she continues to produce, I think Notre Dame's playing hard. I think Virginia Tech is playing hard too. And from here on out, let's take a deep breath and let's go out and execute.
Notre Dame starts off the service, and it's Sydney Palazzolo who's one of the better servers on this team. And an attacking air, we were just mentioning the airs for Virginia Tech, and they'll start the third set with one.
Yeah, it's a little uncommon to start your best attacker or your highest volume attacker with the serve, because now she's three rotations from being front row. A little uncommon. She's a very strong server, though, so that's a good reason. That's a good reason to do it.
And Notre Dame went with her as their first server in the first set as well. And Palazzolo, if you take a look at her numbers, the only member of this Notre Dame team over 20 service aces. In fact, she's into the 30s now. That point will go to Virginia Tech, their first of the third set. And for Virginia Tech, it's got to be a welcome homecoming, a five-game road trip. You got Haley Pierce back on the first game of the road trip on the first of the month at Clemson, but went 1-4 on the road. So being able to return to Castle Coliseum, I know it's not the easiest road, but it's got to feel good to be in front of the home crowd again.
Sure, sleeping in your own bed, eating familiar food. And it's it, when you're trying to take your program from where it's been the last few years, trying to get good, you have to take advantage of home matches that you think you can win. I think that, you know, we were on the call for a match last month against, you know, pretty good Florida State team where Virginia Tech lost 19-17 in the fifth. That's a tough one because you want to win that match. You're probably not supposed to. Whereas here, I think Notre Dame is a match. This is very winnable for Virginia Tech and for Notre Dame. So I think we're going to see, a really fun finish here.
And it's that big block again. Sydney Peterson on the front line as well as Haley Pierce. And it seemed to have been Sydney Peterson who's been on that middle block side for most of this match today for Marcy Byers' squad.
Peterson's been really strong in the middle. She really stepped. Nobody wants to play middle. Nobody wants to play middle. And, you know, she stepped into that role after being primarily an opposite last year. Nobody wants to play middle because it's more work. You got to move two directions. You got to move left and right. If you're right side, you just get to stand there. The hitters come to you. Stand there and block. I think she's been really, really good for Virginia Tech this year, filling a role they desperately needed.
Also now is the server. Tana Board tried to save it, just couldn't quite get there. But was going to mention the early part of the season, Sydney Peterson was subbed out for a server, and now Marcy Byers trusting her enough to get into that server role.
With Olivia Angel out with an injury right now, they're a little bit thin at the defensive specialist spot. Peterson has been around the block and has served well tonight. That kind of standing float serve close to the end line. You just don't see that very often anymore.
Notre Dame.
A throwback serve.
Sorry to cut you off there. Notre Dame, at least the players thought there was a touch on the block. Salima Rockwell decided not to go for that challenge.
Tyler, the players always think there's a touch off the block.
That's a pretty common sight, and a service ace will go the way of Virginia Tech.
If you yell it loud enough, you can sometimes convince the referees that there was a touch off the block. Like that's how the game is played.
Well, it didn't work out for Notre Dame there.
I'm 39 years old, and when I play, and I'm a blocker, and I touch the ball, and go, I mean, I'm all over, clearly off my hands. I still wave my hands. Yell, no, I didn't touch it. It's reflex.
Always trying to get away with something. Well, it's Haley Pierce back to serve, and she got another service ace, and it's been a welcome sight for Virginia Tech to have her back on the hardwood. Board tried to send it over. Instead, it's Lewis. Set will go for the Irish. And another attacking air. This one, Fiona Schrader.
I think this is where the danger zone lies for the Fighting Irish. The serve receive hasn't been particularly strong the last set and a half or so for Notre Dame. Virginia Tech's applying a lot of service pressure. Again, tough serve. Yeah, that's a really, really good serve. An ace from Haley Pierce. It's more than just aces and errors. It's also the bad passes. Watch this good zone five to zone five. So it's the left side of the court serving to Notre Dame's left side of the court. It's the most effective zone-to-zone serve in the game. Also, you're attacking left-side hitters. You're attacking people that have to pass and attack a lot. Another good serve.
For Haley Pierce, three service aces of five Virginia Tech service aces. Block out of bounds will give the side out and the point back to Notre Dame. But for Haley Pierce, a freshman coming into an ACC program and only getting to play really 1.5 non-conference games, able to come in and produce with serves like this against a team like Notre Dame.
Yeah, and you know, on the flip side, she's taking some swings, got some blocks on the right side. That's a high stress swing right there.
Lana Dupre gets it past the middle blockers, and it's Fiona Schrader. Liberos there for Virginia Tech, and Rodriguez, and she'll set for Dupre. Palazzolo blocked, and it hits the hardwood, and it's another block for the Hokies. A block party for Virginia Tech, and this time it's Hannah Borer in on the block.
Yeah, I think Sample here for Notre Dame just leads Palazzolo into the block a little bit. Palazzolo tries to turn a tight set line and ends up going swinging right into the smallest blocker on the court with Borer. Borer makes her pay.
Seven blocks tonight for the Hokies. And it's Palazzolo this time gets the touch off the block and will get the point. What she was trying to do the last time before the Great Wall of Virginia Tech was there. Side out, we'll see. Substitution for the Irish and Maisie Alexander. We've seen her come in all night to do the serving honors. Horror sets, and it's Ava Francis. We've called her name all night, and just able to get a couple touches off the block and through the back row, finally getting it down.
You know, Tyler, I think these are two pretty evenly matched squads here. I know it's a close match, it's easy to say that, but looking at kind of talent and attacking talent and all that kind of stuff, especially with Notre Dame down a starter, down a starting setter here, this kind of this matchup here is very even. It's going to come down to execution. It's not one of those matches where one team is a lot better than the other and can kind of afford to play bad and still win. It's going to be interesting to see each group, how they kind of hold on to that rope as the night progresses, because we're in for one of those 2.5 hour, three hour long five setters maybe, and that really comes down to how mentally strong are you. And it's not, oh, how tough are you, but how tough, you know, can you do the tough things to win?
And well, we talked about it just prior to this set that errors have been the story. That's not an error there from Sydney Peterson, really clean cross-court swing.
Yeah, and if I'm either of these coaching staffs, this is a really nice run here to Peterson. Peterson's high, hard cross-court. If I'm these coaching staffs, someone on each team is designated kind of as a setting coach, run the offense. I'm constantly talking to my setters, reminding them, hey, here's who's producing. Here's who produces for us all the time. Like, don't forget who your best hitters are. That way, when things get tight, end of sets, fifth set maybe, you're setting the right people.
Palazzolo gets back into the rotation as the server. Virginia Tech kind of struggled with that ball, and it's Palazzolo able to set herself up to give a swing from the back row. A dump, Schrader tried to get it down. It did hit the floor, and a point for the Irish.
Yeah, it's a little floor dump here.
And it just seemed like a pancake dig couldn't quite get there.
Another change for Notre Dame here is they have Harmony Sample, an ace here from Palazzolo. Harmony Sample is playing, stayed in to play right side in the front row instead of Lucy Trump coming in for her.
And for Palazzolo, that's her third ace of the night.
So Notre Dame's now running a true 6-2 where both setters stay in the front row to hit. Pretty much nobody does that anymore.
Sarah Cates doing a nice job of recovering the ball way out of bounds. Able to rein it back in. Borer for Francis finds the hardwood. And the Hokies, who had a big lead in this set, had it dwindled by Notre Dame, trying to switch that momentum yet again. And the one thing that this game has lacked has been lead changes. It's almost been whoever took the lead or first to 5 points in a set went on to win that set. Set up. And McDowell put it over. Haley Pierce blocked, and it's the tag team of McDowell and Lang able to give the point to the Irish.
Pierce kind of challenging the block there, kind of a lower set, a little bit inside. You want to be able to take that harder cross or flatten out and swing high off the block.
Solid set. Better dig by Virginia Tech, and it's Haley Pierce trying to swing it over. A bad set. Doesn't quite set up Palazzolo like Notre Dame would have wanted.
Yeah, it's too high. It's just too high for Palazzolo. Palazzolo's looking for something much faster there. So you can see her almost kind of doing that Wile E. Coyote running in the air thing right there before she tries to tip it over and tip it in the net. Got hung out to dry a little bit. That's a good block touch from Kara Lewis.
Swing for Dupre. A solid dig by Lang. Ball goes out of bounds, however, and adds another error to the Notre Dame totals. And, you know, don't like to continue to harp on those airs for Notre Dame, but that's been the story for the Irish.
I think it's a strategy as well. If a team is struggling offensively to execute, then you really need to make them execute again and again and again. Part of it is you want to try and limit your own errors as much as possible and say, okay, we're not going to hit balls out of bounds. We're not going to serve the net. You still want to be aggressive. But in tweener situations, let's defer towards, let's send them a tough roll shot or a tough tip and make them execute. You know, see if they're going to keep producing hitting errors, because right now Notre Dame's hitting zero in set three. Virginia Tech has a two-point lead, only hitting 150. So hitting percentage is your kills minus your errors divided by your total attempts. It's a pretty good one-to-one, kind of with baseball. If you're hitting 300, you're doing all right. If you're hitting 400, you're great. If you're hitting 500, you're an All-American. And so any team hitting, you know, 275, 300, 350 is having a good night.
Now,
zero is bad. Negative is really bad.
Well, you take a look at the numbers so far. In this match as a whole, Notre Dame hitting under 100, Virginia Tech at 221 for the match total. So just two teams. Is it fair to say both teams struggling offensively?
Yes. I think that, you know, 200 is okay from Virginia Tech. That's not typically good enough to win in the ACC. I think both coaching staffs and both sets of players would probably say, hey, we can execute better.
See if Dupre can execute there, and she can. It's out on the far side. And that'll take us to our halfway through the set timeout. A close one in set three. Notre Dame 15-14. Thanks, Nels. And I was talking to Salima Rockwell earlier this week about her past experience as a four-time national champion with her time at Penn State and Texas, and said you understand that you need a foundation of what to expect with work, effort, and expectations for yourself, knows what it takes to build a national championship squad, and she hopes to bring that to the Golden Domes of Notre Dame.
Tyler, I was there at that match in 2012 against Oregon. I was there for the ABCA Coaches Convention, and that was a fun Texas team because, man, for years and years and years, a knock on them before that was they could not win the big one. They didn't pass well enough. They didn't set well enough. You know, they weren't clutch enough, and they always had deep runs and would come up short. Had just come up short the year before, or a couple years before, in the finals. And that year, they had one of my favorite players ever, Cat Bell. They had Cat Bell, Haley Eckerman. They had so many awesome players, and they willed their way to it. It was a great match, great team. How is that not a double?
Well, no call, but Virginia Tech saying ball don't lie. Kara Lewis and Elena Dupre doubling up on the block.
That's like an underhanded double right there. I mean, that was an interesting no call. Yeah, it's a nice block there from Dupre coming up and continuing to play, even though they probably wanted to give up on the play a little bit when they didn't get the whistle. That Texas program has been a fine, fine group for, man, 30 years, 40 years now almost.
Oh, including that national championship run just last year.
Yep. They're good again now. They're good again this year. Jared Elliott has that is not an you know, it's Texas, so it's awesome, it's great. Like, but that is not an easy job. I mean, that is, you are well compensated and you have all the resources, and the pressure is tremendous. I mean, the pressure is tremendous.
Very much like a Nick Saban at Alabama.
Totally. Yeah, absolutely. Or when Salima Rockwell was the assistant, longtime assistant at Penn State, they won four titles in a row. You know, you're expected to win, and the pressure of that is a lot to handle.
Well, Salima Rockwell coming back out of retirement, spent some time in your job, Jake, as a color commentator, including a couple of national championships as well. And then she was talking about how there's a certain number of jobs that if she was offered, she would come out of retirement. Notre Dame was one of those jobs, and she finds herself as the leader of the Fighting Irish.
The only reason I was surprised that she was named the head coach at Notre Dame is I didn't think they could get her. You know, everyone's tried. She's a wonderful person. She's a fantastic coach, one of the best recruiters in the country. Yeah, she's a cool person.
Well, she will take her second or first timeout of the set. Down by three, somewhat late into the set, getting into the later stages. Now, at this point, when you're Salima Rockwell, I was talking to her earlier this week about how her experience in a color commentator role has helped her translate her time as a coach into now being at Notre Dame. Almost gives you a second look. Jake, as a former coach yourself transitioning into this color role, what is the different perspective from being in the fire to stepping back on the air?
Lots of things that I would love to say but can't say on air. But no, I think that I was actually joking around with one of her assistants earlier this week, and I kind of mentioned, like, you know, Rockwell's always been a very good recruiter, and I think it can't hurt that she spent 4 or 5 years kind of being the face of volleyball on ESPN, the big matches, working with Paul Sunderland, who's an Olympian and does the Olympics as a broadcaster. And so, you know, generation of young women turning on ESPN to watch college volleyball. Oh, and Salima Rockwell, oh, now she's a coach, and now she wants me to go play for her. I think it's good. I think that, you know, doing this the last few years, last 6 years now, is give some perspective. And I'm grateful that I see some really tough matches sometimes and see some tough losses for teams. And I'm grateful to not be on the sidelines experiencing
it. There you go.
I get to go home and go to bed and not think about it anymore. I sleep a lot better now, that's for sure.
Well, I was talking to Coach Rockwell earlier this week and asked her about that same question that I just asked you, and she said it was fun to scout both teams at the same time for a big match like the national championship and Final Four. And I'm certain that that helps her now, having to scout only one team or two teams a week during that weekend battle. Virginia Tech inching a little bit closer, now leading by four.
Yeah.
And for Virginia Tech, having Sierra Cates on the floor for the serve. Great dig by Alyssa Menitzis for Notre Dame. Big battle at the net. Well, you talk about a generation of girls growing up and wanting to get into this sport. Is a great swing there for Notre Dame. We all know what happened at Nebraska earlier this season with their match at Memorial Stadium, selling out the biggest attendance for a women's sporting event in history. But Notre Dame just recorded its two biggest crowds in 9 years this past weekend, boasting crowds of over 2,000 for both the match against Virginia and Pitt. So the sport is growing all over the country.
They've got a long tradition of being good at Notre Dame. And I remember back in the early 2000s, kind of mid-2000s, they really had it going on. They got in the top 10 a couple times. And it's definitely a community which supports its programs, especially if you're winning.
Palazzolo, big swing. And this one goes out on Rodriguez, who had a decent attempt at the dig, just a bit too much power behind that swing.
Yeah, that's a hard swing from Rodriguez. And Virginia Tech has made an adjustment in their normal system tonight with Sierra Cates playing. I think that they feel she's more comfortable playing left back as a defensive specialist instead of middle back. So when she's in, good swing there from Peterson. Again, cross court. Notre Dame has struggled to stop Peterson cross-court in the slide. So Rodriguez is now playing middle back for the three rotations that Cates is in. And then Rodriguez moves to her normal left back position for the three rotations that Francis is in the back row with her. So that's an interesting adjustment. It's good to have someone like Ileana Rodriguez who's comfortable playing multiple back row positions. That's going to be a net on Haley Pierce for touching the antenna. So the antenna, for the purposes of a net violation, is considered part of the net. It's illegal to touch the antenna, whether it's below the tape or above the tape. And we'll see Pierce's right hand here. It's a good move. I mean, just gets it. Yeah, she kind of
just nicked it.
Yep. Starts outside, goes to kind of swipe and dive her hands in and touches it.
And a beautiful service ace. Yet another one for Sydney Palazzolo. She's been so good. 25th in the country in service aces per set, and we're seeing it here. Brings the Irish back within two here in a crucial third set. a battle at the net, and it just goes down. A good move there for Charity McDowell. But you talk about how important this set is for both sides. Whoever loses this set now having to play defense, it's a win the set or go home mentality as Virginia Tech and Marcy Byers takes its first time out of the third set. But the winner of this set gets the luxury of knowing that you're 25 points away from winning the match, and you know that the pressure is on the other side.
Yeah, it's obvious. It's clearly huge. It's a very high leverage moment in the match. So when you're in these timeouts, you know, Virginia Tech rotation one here, and so you've got Pierce left front. She's going to pass and hit outside. So she's going to pass and hit middle, usually a two ball run. Peterson on the slide. Look for Peterson on a good pass.
Decent dig, and Bohr.
There's no back row. There's no back row. It's Acker.
It's McDowell, but goes a little too far, and it's another error for Notre Dame, and an untimely one at that.
Yeah, it's Notre Dame really letting the Hokies off the hook there. Poor pass from Virginia Tech. Can't set any of your front row options because two of your three hitters are hitting quick sets there. And so Bohr goes to set back row attack, but there's no back row attacker. It's Sierra Cates out there. She's not going to hit that. That's not her job. Notre Dame bails him out by hitting it out of bounds.
Well, they get it right back. Ava Lang, solid swing.
For Virginia Tech, you got one side out, you got set point. I mean, that's the way you have to look at it. You have a timeout in the bag as well. It's a good swing here from Lang. Just Pierce has got to set that edge a little bit better. She's drifting wide on her block. Make Lang hit down the line.
It's Leva Romanson on the serve. And Dupre blocked. And a great move by Harmony Sample for the Irish.
Yeah, I think I like that matchup. Dupre's played well. She's hit well. Hasn't done a ton in this set. Sample makes a good move.
Tied at 23. Crucial point. And Elena Dupre delivers it to the Hokies.
So the first one was a better set than the second one. And the second one's low and inside here. Dupre does a great job getting to it. Gets the one-on-one. Gets inside of Samples, able to finish cross court.
Good set point. And Peterson sends it wide. We're going to have some extra points here in the third set. So now it's first to 26.
I would have felt good there as Marcy Byers with Sydney Peterson on the line in that spot. She's served well this match so far. Just missed that long.
Harmony Sample, the server for Notre Dame, and it's Dupre. Blocked on a double team by Lauren Tarnoff and Fiona Schrader. It was set point Virginia Tech a little earlier. Now it's set point Notre Dame.
Yeah, it's a good move. Good move to get close there by Tarnoff and finish.
Serve goes over. Bohr sets it up for Lewis. Dug out by Monson and it drops. We're just going back and forth here in set three. A reminder, it's a win by two, so now it's first to 27. And it's Haley Pierce, who's done such a great job serving, kind of the role you want for Virginia Tech in that server spot right now.
Look for Lang getting set over Bohr here. Now they're going to have to go to Lang.
They do go to Lang, try to get it through. And it's Lewis on a soft set back over. Tip off the block, and the set's for Lewis. Goes back over, but out, and it's set point Virginia Tech, their second different set point of this set.
I think on both of those swings from Lewis and Bohr, I think a year ago, Bohr dumps both of these balls. She really was looking to call her own number there. I think it's a sign of her maturity, especially on the first swing, not so much in the second. Now, she works hard. She makes herself available. She gets a lot of kills because she's on time and there. We'll see what kind of solution Notre Dame has here on set point.
Haley Pierce, the freshman, will be set up for Lang. Blocked, is that in? No, they roll it out and they give it back to Notre Dame, so we're going back and forth.
We're
going to
get a challenge here from Marcy Byers. It's very close.
I mean, that was right in front of us.
It's right in front of us. Unfortunately, because it's right in front of us, we have a pretty terrible angle.
Yeah.
I would believe either way. To me, it looked out live, but, you know, that's right on the line, and it's also directly beneath the R1. We'll get a pretty good look at it right here. It's definitely touched by the block. No question about that.
So if it's out, that is as close as it comes.
So All right, so the theory is, and this is the way that line judges are taught, the ball compresses, just like in tennis. The ball compresses. Here's another really good look. That ball's out. The ball compresses. That ball's hard hit. That ball is going to compress and get a catch piece of that line. That ball's not hard hit. It's like just taking it, holding out in front of you, just dropping it. So to me, that ball is pretty clearly out. There's also a reason that I don't officiate, is that I often get this wrong.
Well, Virginia Tech, if it's called out, Virginia Tech wins the set 27. If it's called in, Virginia Tech would win the set. Now, this is a longer challenge than we've seen so far. Wade Brents, who is the alternate official, is the man with the computer at the replay system right now. So this is the biggest replay challenge of the game so far.
This would be a... Now, what he's doing right now is he's checking with the scorekeepers, making sure everyone's on the same page. Wow, in.
And they called it in point for the Hokies. That call's overturned. So Virginia Tech now wins the set, puts Notre Dame on the ropes for the fourth set. Huge challenge and a huge overturned call for Virginia Tech. They lead 2-1, try to finish the job when we come back for the fourth set. Coming up on the ACC Network Extra. Hokies have a 2-1 set lead in a large part due to Ava Francis. Jake, what have you seen from the redshirt sophomore?
She's been aggressive. I think that Hannah Bohrer has put her in good spots as well, and she's taken some smart swings. She has a little bit of a longer arm swing, so I think personally she does a little bit better when that set's a touch higher. It gives her a chance to kind of get her arm swing all the way through the ball. And when she's on, when she's in rhythm, she hits a very heavy ball and is very effective.
Ava Francis, the kill leader for Virginia Tech so far tonight. 10 just behind her, Elena Dupre with 9. And the Hokies will get the first service here in set 4. Having the Irish on the ropes, a big overturned call at the end of set 3 has cost the Irish now having to play a very defensive and conservative game to just try to win this set and stay in it.
I think you got to go for it, Tyler. It's the exact opposite. You have to try and take control of the match, finding your offense, serving tougher. I think that, you know, Palazzolo served well. That's been about the limit. I think Samples served pretty well, too, from the center spot. I'm curious about that adjustment to go away. We're going to get a little bit of a change here, actually, for Notre Dame, that Sample is setting, but Trump has come back in to play the front row right side spot, but she's playing for Schrader now instead of Sample, so we'll see what they do with Schrader.
Hannah Bohrer begins the service for Virginia Tech. Sophomore out of Lewis Center. A service error will give it straight back to Notre Dame, and we've seen now all 4 sets. The first rotation for the Irish has seen Palazzolo in that server role. And so good tonight.
Yeah, she's been a real difference maker from the service line. That's and 5. Effectively, it's not an ace, but that's an ace, you know.
Well, Charity McDowell able to finish the job just on a dig that almost went back over, did go back over the net for McDowell. Just to stuff right back. And a rare service error for Sydney Palazzolo.
I like it because she's also challenging the corners. She challenges the edges of the court. Very effective server.
It passes it back over to Ava Francis. Plain City, Ohio native. Got her first service ace of the year earlier today, but she'll get this rotation with a quick service error and a side out, giving it back to the libero for Notre Dame in Hattie Monson. Senior for Salima Rockwell's squad. Heavy swing for Peterson towards the bench. And Monson, just not enough power to get it back over the net. Peterson takes over as the server. Transfer from the Nevada Wolfpack, going from coast to coast. Not too often that you see a player from the West Coast transition over to the East Coast.
Long way to go from Reno to Blacksburg.
It's been working for Sydney Peterson. Now she touches it out of bounds, gives a point over to Notre Dame.
They've got Lake Tahoe, but I think the weather's better out here.
The leaves are changing now. Getting into that Virginia Tech maroon and orange around here for the Hokies. Bohr sets it up, but Lewis wasn't on the same page.
This would be the interesting thing here. Once Lucy Trump is here done serving, does she come out for Schrader, or do they leave Sample in to run a 5-1?
Lucy Trump, solid serve.
So I asked Selima Rockwell before the match, you're running a 5-1 or a 6-2? She goes, yes. So.
Almost matching what Virginia Tech has been doing in mixing up those two formations.
Here comes Schrader for Trump. So, 6-2.
Haley Pierce has been the top server for Virginia Tech. She'll take over as the server for the Hokies.
The interesting thing for me, I not knowing what the thought process here is, Sample playing front row, had that big block at the end of set three, contributing there, but they're not setting her. You know, she's only taken two swings. One of those was when she was setting that kind of floor dump, that back row dump.
Ellie Pierce high, but it just dives down, hits the line. Great serve for Pierce. And almost the definition of a line shot there for Haley Pierce.
Yeah, it's a drop and float serve.
Yet another ace.
That's going to be a back row attack, yep. And that's where you run into some troubles with the back with running, you know, 6-2 constant back row setters. You pass tight. Schrader's got nothing she can do there. She ends up making the back row attack violation.
Gives Haley Pierce some more time to continue her time serving. She's got five aces tonight, but a solid kill by Lauren Tarnoff just gets off the dig right arm of Ileana Rodriguez. Allows it to go out, and a side out ends that dangerous Pierce serve. Alyssa Menitzis serving for Notre Dame, and it's a service error. Now, meanwhile, for Virginia Tech, trying to stay level-headed. For more on that, we'll pass it on over to Nels Williams.
Thanks, Tyler. I was over by the and Coach Byers seemed to be extremely calm, tranquil, and level. Seems like Virginia Tech definitely is not going to let anxieties and the jitters get to them during this right now. And it certainly seems like Coach Byers is hoping that the Hokies can keep their mentality calm and collected. Guys.
Well, so far, just taking a look at the Virginia Tech squad on the floor, it certainly seems like there is that calm and tranquil mood despite the set being tied. And I know it's early, but still a tied set is a more tranquil or a less tranquil environment than one in which you have the lead.
I'm a big believer in don't panic, because there will be plenty of time for that later. Like, you want to try and play even, you know, play at an elevated level. You want to be alert and trying to play well and play with energy. But if you try and get that roller coaster of up and down and up and down and pure emotion, you can only sustain that for so long.
Palazzolo will earn the kill for Notre Dame. Seeing a substitution, Trump checking back in for the Irish. Server, meanwhile, is Harmony Sample, the sophomore from Louisville, Texas. Set for Bohr and Francis. A touch off the block and a point for the Hokies.
That's a nice swing from Ava Francis right there. She kind of shortens up her arm swing, goes a little bit of a crossbody, kind of a shot there to play this off the block. Watch her full approach and then just that little easy kind of thumb up in the air, crossbody swing to tool the block.
It was the newly checked in Lucy Trump, went off her arm, and a solid cross-court swing for Palazzolo goes out on the Hokies.
The reality is, at the highest levels, you have to have multiple shots. You cannot just go up and just purely rip every time unless you're, you know, an Olympian or something like that. But to have those extra shots, to be able to beat a block when you have a double block, that's the kind of the next step for collegiate-level players.
We're seeing the Sidney Palazzolo serve yet again, and it's another one of those situations where the dig on Virginia Tech's side rebounds back over the net, and it goes into the net that time for Palazzolo. But we've seen that a couple of times tonight where the dig just goes back over and it gives Notre Dame that big advantage.
I mean, she's generated, she has four aces. We've seen two overpass kills just this set. She's probably generated 12 or 15 points off of her serve tonight for her team. That's a very good performance. And the fact that she has three service errors, if it's me coaching, I don't care. It's fine. She's generating tons of points.
Nice. She'll certainly take the errors when it's a risk versus reward.
Call this four contacts. They're going to say that the ball touched Borer before the bump set.
Marcy Byers talking to Wade Brentz, the alternate official.
Yeah.
Not much you can do.
They're going to say that Borer tried to get out of the way before Pierce bump set it cross court to Dupre. And their first official saying that the ball touched Borer before Pierce, making Dupre swing four contacts.
Borer will set for Dupre. Notre Dame leading by just narrowest of margins, 1 point. And Peterson, a soft hit. And it forces Palazzolo to bump it from the back row. Set up for Lang. Good dig for Dupre. Solid volley here. Lang dug out again. Rodriguez sets up for Dupre. Middle blockers there. Ball refusing to hit the hardwood. Set. Trump tried to finish. It's there for Peterson. And it's a point for the Hokies. Goes in for Sidney Peterson. Just a huge volley going back and forth. Neither team should have lost that point, but Peterson doing a nice job of finishing through some adversity.
Yeah, this is a really good finish here from Peterson. You know, running that quick middle off that kind of good pass or off that free ball. When you're in these long rallies, you want to be able to transition to a quick middle because it's a highly efficient swing. And then Peterson rotates back in a great serve. That big net there. That's Pierce trying to make a play. They're asking a lot of Haley Pierce tonight. As a true freshman, hasn't played, missed a lot of time this year. She's played six rotations. They're setting her a fair amount. They're setting her in the back row. Ask her to pass, good pass.
Well, Pierce will get the swing here and the kill. Sends it off about three Notre Dame arms before it goes into the tunnel.
I know that the Virginia Tech staff was very high on Pierce coming into this year. Kind of the centerpiece of that recruiting class. It must have hurt a lot to have her miss so much time with that broken knuckle, but again, she's carrying a big load. She's just hitting over zero right now, but she's passing, she's blocking, playing some defense. Oh!
She's back as server. Great attempt for Virginia Tech. Couldn't quite get it back over the net. It's a point for the Irish.
Yeah, Rodriguez got caught leaning the wrong way. Almost made the play reaching back.
And we'll see Ava Lang, the true freshman for Notre Dame. Solid serve, low on the net. Pierce able to get it back over. A big swing there, Lauren Tarnoff earns the kill. Irish go back up by two. Seems like one of their bigger leads in recent memory.
Yeah, this is a good transition run here to Tarnoff. Lewis just out of position. She's too far to the right side of the court. She needs to go body to body at the very least against Tarnoff.
Drops on the floor and Notre Dame now going on a run. This is exactly what the Irish need. They have some time to talk about it. Virginia Tech trying to rebound. Momentum's with the Irish in set four. Stay tuned. Fun one here at Castle on the ACC Network Extra. Sidney Palazzolo has been a big part of this Irish team. Jake, when you talk about a star player like this for Notre Dame, what does has she meant in this game specifically for Salima Rockwell's squad?
She's been tremendously impactful. 16 kills, hit 225, taking all the tough swings, 9 digs, about to have a double-double. And she has been, by a wide margin, the most effective server in the match as well, really causing problems for Virginia Tech from the service line. Now she has, we knew she was going to be a big piece tonight given how well she's performed throughout the year leading in, and she's really stepped up after kind of a slow start.
Well, she will be on the floor for Notre Dame after a serve by Lang. Palazzolo right there.
I mean, she better be on the floor.
Coach Rockwell said earlier this week they don't like to take her off the floor. They want her in there for every single point if they can let her.
If Salima Rockwell tried to sub her out, I might have to run out there and stop her. She's been great tonight. Again, she struggled to start the match, and she wasn't super effective. And then, you know, as if you're not having the night or the match you want to have, you want to try and build as we get a challenge here looking for a touch off the block. You want to try and build your game up by doing the basic things. Let's find something I do well. Sure, tonight, her serving's been great. Okay, now I'm serving well. Let's see if I can play a little defense, make a dig. Let's see if I can get a kill on a great set. And then as the match has gone on, she's gotten more and more involved and really has taken over.
We have a challenge on another touch off the block. This was overturned in the past. This one's off the right hand of Bohrer. The question is, does that finger move? It's hard to tell.
It's hard to tell. Oh, that's a better look. That's touch. That's touch for
sure. You can see there, kind of two fingers get lost in the shadow, kind of bending back on the ring and middle finger of Bohrer's right hand.
Touch.
And they will call it a touch.
All right.
And pretty clear look there.
All right.
Well, Jake, Notre Dame now having a decent lead in this set, 16-12 after the review. What have they done differently, or what has worked better in this set?
Well, they're hitting 529 and have no hitting errors, or only one hitting error, I'm sorry. That is the, our stats just updated because of the challenge. 647 on 17 swings with no hitting errors after hitting like under 100 for the first three sets. That's the difference. I mean, Virginia Tech's hitting pretty well too, 357. But, you know, Notre Dame's offense coming alive is really the difference in set four.
Elena Dupre couldn't get quite underneath that ball, and it ends up falling short. The Irish have now built a 5-point lead in a must-win set here in set four.
Yeah.
Ava Lang sends it over. Bohrer sets for Dupre, and it's a touch off the block at point for the Hokies.
So what happens if you're serving well, you start to generate more bad offense from your opponent, and so you get weaker swings, more controllable digs, free balls back, you know, where they can't run, where Virginia Tech can't run offense. And so as your serving gets better, it tends to also boost your own offense because you're getting easier first contacts.
A high attempt for Harmony Sample. Kara Lewis tries to punch it back over. It's Francis, but she's blocked by Sample. The Texas native able to get in there on the block for the Irish.
You got to know where you are here for Avery Francis. Bump set, you're obviously getting doubled, and that's right down the seam. That is right down the seam of the block. Any team that's worth playing against is going to be all over that. You have to look high hands. Hit as hard as you can off the top of the block. Hit a roll shot. Hit a tip. You're probably not getting a kill. Same situation right there. You're in the same spot. You've got to find a way to work around the block, over the top.
Leva Francis blocked on a second consecutive point, and the Irish just using that big block, and it's Charity McDowell again.
The other thing is, like, you got to cover better if you're Virginia Tech. I mean, one person was covering hard, a bunch of people kind of standing around. You know that Ava Francis is in a really bad situation there. You have to get up underneath the point of attack and sell out.
Irish wins on those points. Sophomore from Portland, Oregon. It's a great story, not only on the court, but off as well. Back in Oregon, volunteered at the Hurtado Center, which teaches immigrating adults' English and citizenship tests. So a great cause off the court for Maisie Alexander, as well as doing great on the court.
That's cool.
And is unable to give her team the point there. A attacking error by Notre Dame will give the point back to Virginia Tech and sees Ileana Rodriguez now serve. The New York native. Played internationally for the Dominican Republic at the Pan American Games.
I think she's been a very strong addition for the Connecticut this year. Not super flashy from the libero spot. Some liberos are flashy. I don't think Rodriguez is. She makes a ton of plays, though. Very good receiver. Plays well in left back.
Well, Rodriguez has looked good and has been consistent for Virginia Tech as well. Palazzolo tried to get it through the block and did, but Virginia Tech recovered. Solid dig by Cates. Bohr will just set it over to reset the touches. Palazzolo block hitting off the antenna, and the point will go to the Irish. We'll see Harmony Sample become the server.
That's a pretty easy one right there. Off four, off the block. We've had Elizabeth Aylward coming to the mat here on the left side. Jasmine Robinson's been in as well in the middle. Marcia Byers trying to find some solutions here down big.
We'll get a whistle, another point over to Notre Dame.
I don't like that call, Tyler. We don't make that call anymore. I mean, we decided years ago that that's not what we're going to do. I didn't like that decision years ago to loosen up those second contacts. They don't call the setters when they butcher a ball. Why are they calling a middle when they butcher the ball?
Haley Pierce's swing that goes out, and now the momentum almost seems insurmountable on a 23-15 lead with Notre Dame 2 points away from winning the fourth set.
Oh, yeah. Your win percentage here is probably like 97%, 98%.
Harmony Sample still the server. This time it's Elizabeth Aylward, has only checked in for the fourth set and earns a kill. Aylward, the freshman out of Nashville, Tennessee.
Got a pretty significant amount of time up at Boston College last weekend for Virginia Tech.
Has achieved a bigger role since the road win against Syracuse. Big block there. Aylward and Peterson team up to stuff the ball back towards Notre Dame's end of the court.
That's a nice move here by Aylward. All over. You can see that. Stops her outside move to stay inside, set the edge there. Good move on the block.
Four for Peterson, but that block party. And it will go back towards Virginia Tech. And Salima Rockwell will call a timeout after seeing a three and louder for the hometown team in Virginia Tech. Not to mention Virginia Tech has the advantage of being the serving team. Hannah Bohrer with the ball in her hands. Bohrer, sharp line drive on the serve. Palazzolo with the big swing. And a swing for Haley Pierce, able to find the hardwood. Hokies making a little bit of a run, a 4-0 run for Virginia Tech currently.
I think Virginia Tech might have got away with one there. I had a Virginia Tech blocker in the net on that swing. Palazzolo, for Trump.
Palazzolo will deliver the swing here, however. Set up for Aylward, and it's off the net and the block. The point will go towards Notre Dame. Set point for the Irish, and a solid five-point cushion.
Yeah, that's where you need to find a way to convert. In that out-of-system situation, you got to kind of take that swing off around the edges of the block here. Now Notre Dame's best server and best player.
Palazzolo, we've talked about how good she is as a server. Can Virginia Tech find a way to get 5 points out of her? And we'll go out, and Virginia Tech able to get the side out, getting back into their comfort zone when the Hokies are serving. We'll see Elizabeth Aylward be subbed out here in place of Ava Francis to do the serving here late in the fourth.
Francis can have a big serve. She's made some service errors tonight, five of them.
Francis is going to need to get at least 4 points for her team in a row. Big swing there, and Lang will finish off the fourth set. Well, two evenly matched teams. We've been talking about it all night. We're tied at two sets. It's a best of 15 fifth set. Coming up next, we got an exciting finish on the ACC.
It's going to be crazy. They're stressful. And matchups, hitter-blocker matchups, matter enormously. And we'll get Palazzolo here to start the set.
Coin toss gave Notre Dame the first serve, and it's Palazzolo. Immediate swing by Francis puts Notre Dame on the defensive, and Palazzolo, an attacking error, gives the Hokies first blood in the fifth set.
So I think that matters in a big way because you broke Palazzolo's serve. You know, the best server in the match, you broke her serve to start the set. And now in a short set to 15, Palazzolo starts in the back row. It's three more rotations before she comes up front to be a front row attacker. So that reduces the amount of time that she spends as a hitter in her most effective position.
Big swing by Lang. And for Notre Dame, you benefit from having not only Palazzolo, but you have Lang, who's been a heavy hitter so far.
Yeah, I think it's less of a drop-off than it might normally because Lang's having a nice night. But that opportunity, I think it's a right call, that opportunity to have Palazzolo maybe start some matches with four aces. Oh, what a filthy serve.
This one will drop in favor of Notre Dame, taking a quick lead here in set five. 2-1, still early in the fifth set.
Bottom fell out of that one from Monson.
Again. Monson hits the net, four for Peterson. And it's set up Lang on the swing again. Rodriguez over to Pierce. Swing will come from Trump. Coming forward, Pierce. Tough spot for Notre Dame.
It's tight.
Get out of it. Yep. But over on the front line, the middle blockers, Haley Pierce, Sydney Peterson, stuff it home.
Sweet. Yeah, this is just really, really super tight overpass there. Easy cleanup by Pierce. We talked earlier, Tyler, about continuing to communicate with your team and your setters. Who is hitting well?
A big block there. And a whistle will give the point to Notre Dame on a violation. The alternate official called it.
And a net call here on somebody. Man, that's so rare to get a block like that, have him call net. Got to be Dupre. From that angle, it's hard to see, but it's got to be Dupre.
And a service ace immediately following that up. Notre Dame taking the momentum. Lucy Trump with the service ace.
I'd almost take a timeout here and just settle. That was a really quick three-point swing, really, between the net call and the ace.
Trump low, hard hit serve. Pierce sends it back over. Nice digs for Notre Dame. Bohr over to Pierce. Another whistle called. This time it will be in favor of Virginia Tech. So two violations back to back cancel each other out.
Yeah, that's Lang in the net there on the block as well. I was saying earlier, you want to make sure you're communicating who are our best attackers, who is performing well. So when things get tight here, that you're making the confident, making the right choice and sending the right people. Try to hold onto that rope as long as possible.
Set up for Tarnoff. Now Bohrer for Dupre. Hard hit swing, but it goes a little too far wide. An attacking error. And the story of the match, the story we keep coming back to, has been errors and giving your opponent points.
It's not been a particularly clean offensive performance from either team tonight.
This time it's Kara Lewis able to find the hardwood. So we'll take a substitution. We'll see Sierra Cates come in to serve.
I think that Kara Lewis can be a factor here at the end of the match. She's only taken 19 swings through four and change sets here. She's a highly efficient attacker. They haven't seen a lot of her. Force her the ball if you can.
Big swing and just a collision between Pierce and Rodriguez gives the point to Notre Dame. Well, a big part of that is in between sets, Marcy Byers was telling her team about holding each other accountable, and that's a situation where you have to hold each other accountable when there's that collision on the floor.
Good pass.
Setting it up for Ava Francis. And a good dig attempt by Maisie Alexander just gets past the pancake.
That's an awesome, awesome pass from Sierra Case right there. That ball is right down the line. That's a tough, tough serve. She sticks that. Look at that move. Perfect pass. Three-point pass. Gets Francis essentially a huge flip block to put it away. What a big, big play from someone who doesn't receive a lot of serves.
Ileana Rodriguez gets a service ace of her own. We're tied at sixes.
Good if you're Virginia Tech. There's that moment of, oh no, are we gonna give up a lead? We can't come back from it. Now you've tied it at six. You've put yourself right back in the match.
Rodriguez sends it over. Barely any spin on that ball. Rodriguez with the dig. Bohr for Peterson. Blocked, and now Bohr has to reset, this time for Pierce. And it's off of the freshman Manitsis. And the Hokies have the lead a point away from a timeout and a change of court.
Yeah, that's a good back row swing here from Haley Pierce off the soft block cover. Set to Peterson, just high, hard cross court. Make them make a play, make them dig it.
This time it gets canceled out. Ileana Rodriguez with a service error. Ties it at seven.
Tyler, one thing to keep an eye on here, Peterson running the quick one ball right in front of the setter. Notre Dame is keying on that pretty hard. They brought left side blocker in Palazzolo to help block on that. I think that running Peterson on the slide is going to open things up for both her and Ava Francis here if they can get the pass.
Bohr sets up. Change of court after this point.
Oh,
and it's a beautiful swing by Palazzolo. Gets the kill. Notre Dame heads out. 8-7 lead in the fifth set. We got a fun one here at Castle on the ACC Network Extra. So far today, has not had too many serves of note. No aces nor errors. Has been consistent. Rodriguez to Bohr.
Big swing.
It's Ava Francis finding the hardwood.
Big swing. You can see that kind of longer, loopier arms that Ava Francis has. When she gets all the way through, she has a ton of power. This is exactly where she's at her best. High, hard, cross court. There's nobody there.
Set for the Irish. A swing, and it's Palazzolo. Flag goes up, and they're calling it an attacking error.
I thought that ball was touched live. I think everybody else thought that ball was touched live. I mean, that was a really, really nasty inside-out swing there from Palazzolo. She set a little inside. We're getting the challenge here from Sleema Rockwell. She set inside on that five set, that back set, and instead of just staying with it and coming cross, she kind of turns inside out, turns her thumb down, and try and takes that thing off the block. I thought she made the swing. We get no touch call from anybody. Everybody's supposed to be looking for a touch. I thought I saw one. We'll see it here.
Notre Dame certainly thought they saw one, and we'll get a look.
You can see this inside swing right there. Maybe not, man.
I might see the pinky finger there of Ava Francis on the left hand.
Maybe?
I thought
she touched it live. Here's a good look. You can see, you don't really see that inside out look there, but the natural inclination is to go hard cross. And that's a touch. She turns that thing down the line. She kind of does what you're not supposed to do there tactically, and makes a really, really good swing there, I think. Yeah.
And Notre Dame will get that call. So that's a big swing. It determined the lead, so instead of 9-8 Tech, it's now 9-8 Notre Dame.
And I don't think that's going to be a shocker to Virginia Tech that got overturned. I'm sure Francis went to Marcy Byers and said, yeah, I touched it, so let's get ready for being down 9-8 rather than hoping and praying.
Well, now the rotation has gone back to the beginning. Sydney Palazzolo, who's been the best server of the game so far, is back on that line.
So you get less of her as an attacker, but more of her as a server.
And she'll get another service ace. And so Sydney Palazzolo, yet another service ace. She's been so good at those so far tonight. That's her fifth. Solid swing by Ava Francis. And this is a touch by Notre Dame that goes out, puts Virginia Tech back within a point.
Yeah, it's a big swing here again from Ava Francis. Out of system ball, takes a hard swing. Montz just quite can't handle it. I'm sure she wants that one back.
Now Salima Rockwell talking during the change of court about keeping all the little things in mind. And there's one of the little things that turns into a big thing. Pass the air through the antenna on the far side, gives another point to the Hokies.
Yeah, I think Sample has struggled a little bit on these back sets, especially when she has to move forward. It's not a great pass. That one just got away from her a little bit, got wide on Trump.
It's now a first to five. Yep. We'll get a whistle.
That's Sample in the net on a tight pass. Again, this is a little more shaky serve receive here from Notre Dame.
We'll get a timeout by Salima Rockwell's squad.
Heart when you lose. And I guess that's why we do it. That's why you play sports and things, but you hope that your team can go out and just execute, because it's really fun and really cool when they do.
Well, this is a game that neither team really deserves to lose. There's been so much fight on both sides of the net.
See if Francis makes another good serve here. Look for Trump here on a good pass.
Instead, it's a service ace for Ava Francis. Couldn't have come at a better time.
And that's legit in, too. You know, every team's always going to have a coach or a staff member sitting on the end of the bench right on that end line so they can see that ball's in by 10 inches. It's a great serve from Francis. Another good one.
It forces Trump to rebound. Palazzolo blocked.
Good cover.
McDowell tried to get it over.
Just got to send a free ball.
Rodriguez sets up for Pierce. It's hit off the block, it goes out, and Virginia Tech has the momentum, 2 points away from their second ACC win of the season.
Yeah, we're gonna get another timeout here from Notre Dame. Big out-of-system swing here from Haley Pierce. You know, she, as a freshman, playing six, solid night, 258, leading the team in hitting percentage right now. Ava Lang, Charity McDowell, and Lucy Trump. I would have said Trump on a good pass earlier, but they're not passing well. See if you can use McDowell and Trump to get Peterson pinned to the middle of the floor as a blocker, and then set Lang over Haley Pierce and see if she can take the freshman one-on-one.
It's Ava Francis yet again. The Hokies a point away from match. Big swing by Lang, and it's in. A beautiful side out for Notre Dame. Really needed that.
Yeah, they got a pretty good pass right there. A solid pass. I'd say a medium pass. Pushes. That's a really nice location there from Sample. Really getting that ball all the way out there for Lang. Nice swing from Lang, too.
Serve comes from Monson. Dupre with the swing, and it's off of Monson's block. And it's match point, Virginia Tech, in a match that's gone back and forth. The Hokies look to capitalize right here.
Big swing there from Elena Dupre. Been kind of quiet here in set five. Big cross-court hard swing.
Sydney Peterson. The set and kill by Lucy Trump. Able to keep the Irish alive.
14-12 here. The interesting thing is Marcy Byers, who tends to not... She has a habit of not using all of her timeouts. She still has two in the bag here, so I think if you don't win it here, it's an immediate timeout. I'm going Dupre here over Sample.
Well, it's Borer over to Lewis. This one drops, and Notre Dame is a point away from being able to give up a point and stay alive in this match. And it will be down to Lucy Trump as the server.
A little bit of a force there to Kara Lewis. See if they can get in system here. Rodriguez has to step in.
Borer sets over to Dupre. And that's in. Virginia Tech will win it in five.
We're going to get a challenge here, it looks like.
Salima Rockwell going straight over to the green coach's challenge card. We're not done quite yet. And this is just a challenge that you have to have for Salima Rockwell.
Totally, absolutely. There's nothing to lose here. That's why you keep him in your pocket.
We'll see where this lands.
In. Yeah, in all the way.
Yep, that's a pretty...
That's a fantastic look at it from our crew.
Virginia Tech will win it in five sets. An exciting one here from Castle Coliseum. Virginia Tech wins it 3-2. Their first win over Notre Dame